Hey everyone! So today I'm going to be filming a makeup tutorial. It's going to be inspired by Whitney Port. I was obsessed with The Hills on MTV, and I liked Whitney. I thought that she was really pretty and she was really nice, so I'm going to do a tutorial inspired by her. So first I moisturize my skin like I always do. Now I'm just going to conceal everything before I put my foundation on, because Whitney has quite a flawless coverage. So I'm going to use my NYX concealer in Porcelain with just an e.l.f. concealer brush and just conceal some spots that I have. So now I'm going to take Maybelline New York Concealer in the color Sand Sable, and it's more yellow, and I seem to have a little bit more redness today, so I'm going to use that just to kind of cancel out some of the redness that I have. Now I'm going to conceal my under eye with the Maybelline Instant Age Rewind Dark Circle Eraser, and I'm just going to take this like under my eyes and then kind of like in a V shape to lighten up right here. Use a foundation, Thermal Match Perfection, and the color True Ivory. I'm just going to take a Real Techniques Expert Paste Brush, I love this thing, and just work the foundation into my skin. So now I'm just going to set my foundation using the Rimmel Stay Matte Powder. And once again, I'm just going to kind of push this into my skin. I'm not going to, like, work it back and forth because I don't want to take off the foundation I just put on. So now I'm going to fill in my eyebrows, but first I'm just going to brush through them. I'm going to use the Revlon Color Stay palette, and I'm going to use this color right here. So next are the eyes, and first I'm just going to prime them with the e.l.f. Eyelid Primer. I told you guys I would tell you what I think about it, and I've been using it the past couple days, and it's not as bad as I thought it was going to be. It covers up pretty well, and my eyeshadow seems to last a little bit longer, but I think I really want to try the Primer Potion by Urban Decay, because I'm sure that's like, so much better. This was only like a dollar, but it works well for me, speaking of a dollar. So Whitney Port tends to have like a really bright and shimmery eyeshadow with like a really thick black eyeliner, so that's what that I'm going to be doing today. So I'm going to be using this color right here from the BH palette, Day and Night, and this is just like on an e.l.f. eyeshadow brush. And we just sweep this all across our lid. And then for the crease color, sometimes she does like a brown, but I'm gonna do more like a peach kind of color, just because I feel like it would, you know, be a little more subtle. So I'm going to use... So I'm going to use this color from the same... I'm going to use this color from the same palette. She does keep her eyes relatively light, so... Or the look that I'm basing this off of. I'm just going to take a fluffier brush and then just kind of blend the top of this and the crease color and the base color together a little bit. So now as a highlight, I'm just going to take like a white color, this one from the BHJ Night palette, and I'm just going to put a little bit on a brush like this and go under my brow bone. Just really highlight that because she emphasizes the highlight too. I'm going to take the crease color, put it on an angle brush, and then run it on my lower lash line just for a little bit of definition. Now it's time to add the thick line of eyeliner to the upper lash line and wing it out just a little bit. Now she tends to add like a really thick line. I don't know how good it's gonna look on my eye shape, so I'm not gonna do like very thick, but I'm gonna do a little thicker than what I usually do. So the thickness just really depends on your style and your eye shape. So I am going to be using the NYC liquid eyeliner, and this is just in like black. But if you wanna stay, we can dodge all the things that try to get in our way. Get out of our way. And they'll say it's too soon. Shrinking my lids apple blue. Hearts prolific in blame you. As lovely large as great as on a moon. Now I'm just going to add some black mascara, and I'm going to be using the Benefit Their Real mascara. And I really like this this eyeliner look. I think it's really cute. So first I'm going to contour my cheekbones just a little bit, just so I don't know, it looks like I have cheekbones, but now it doesn't. I'm going to take the Rimmel Natural Bronzer in the color Sun Bronze, just on an e.l.f. blush brush, and just make a funny face and contour my cheekbones. For blush, Whitney either does like a really like tan color, or she does like a pink. So I think that I'm going to do like a pink color, this color right here. Like I said, she really emphasizes her blush, so if you don't like this strong of like a blush look, you definitely can take it lighter, but I think that it's different than what I usually wear, and I kind of want to try some different things in my makeup. I'm going to take the CoverGirl Jumbo Gloss Balm. This is the color Watermelon. I'm just going to take a little bit of clear lip gloss and just put it over that so it's not like really strong. Okay, so this is the finished Whitney Port-inspired makeup look. I actually really like this look. I think it's really pretty. Nothing too overdramatic or anything. I'm excited to wear this out. Let me know what you guys think. Don't forget to hit the like button that's down below, and please subscribe. Also, check out my blog. I'll have it linked below, and if you happen to miss my last video, I'll also link that down below in the description box. I really hope you guys enjoyed this look. I will see you guys next time. Bye!